Greetings from Mucus Asylum Stadium in Luniapolis, Craziana, where fans are burning effigies of GM Crying Pigskin in protest of his latest trade that sent three players to Green Bay in exchange for a sack of toasters. The teams are juiced up and ready for blood as they take the field for MFL action. The Motor City Maniacs battle the Insane Colts. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Welcome to another game day here on the MFL Network. Grim Blitzrow along with my partner, Brickhead Mulligan.
How you doing?
Great city, isn't it, Bricks?
Fantastic city. My motel even has free color TV.
Oh, that's nice.
An ice machine that works.
Wow.
There was police tape blocking the bathroom because of the photographers in there, but other than that, no complaints. They give you free jelly at breakfast, too.
Sounds like a real winner. And it's first and 10. His way out of that. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
Huh. I didn't know that was a penalty.
Yeah, these rule changes are ruining the game, Grim.
Second down and long. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. And the defense was ready for that bombs away dirty trick that time. And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
And he's got a chance for a good return here. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Intercepts the ball.
Thank you very much, sister.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I'll bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and 10. Potato 4. The defense just blew up a player who thought he was going to score. Oh, that hot potato dirty trick gets him every time. And it's first and 10. That pathway nets them 7 yards.
Oh, no. I got the hiccups again. What are you supposed to do to get rid of them again?
You stick it in the plastic bag, say the alphabet backwards while you set yourself on fire and jump out the window. It ought to stop them.
Second and 3. And he catches it for a touchdown. What a beautiful play.
Yeah, it's almost poetic, man. Like a haiku.
Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 on that play. Second down and 5. You've got to catch that. Third down and 5. This dirty trick. The quarterback unleashes him, and the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Il.
This didn't need any drug testing in the MFL, because whatever they juiced that player with to make him run that fast can't be legal. Third down and 9. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
And it's first and 10. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Man, he really wants it.
And it's first and 10. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. First and 10. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Second down and 6. And they line up for the extra point. It's good. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. And this game is up for grabs. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner.
You can't keep a good mutant.
Pow! With the brain scrambler! And it's first and 10. That's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. Second down and 2.
It's a zap attack. It's like when you shuffle your...
And he fumbles it, Bricks. That was a screwed up play. He zigged when he should have zagged and ends up a shish kebab. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. The 20. Here comes the defense. Oh, and they got him. That's a touchdown saving tackle. First down and 1. It shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Time the spikes and ends up dead.
Life is full of misery, Grim. Loneliness, suffering, and then it's over much too soon.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably grabbed his pants.
It's first and 10. Oh, with the brutal hit. And that'll bring up second and 1. Killer, it was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. First down. It's first and ten. Second down, and ain't gonna happen, partner. He had it for a second there. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. And they went to the air and came up big. And kickers practice for this kind of kick every day. Pretty standard.
Nothing standard when you got bloodthirsty mutants on the defensive line.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty...
Another bullshit penalty. How long are these guys going to take this?
Oh, boy, there.
Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery.
The refs certainly take a lot of abuse in this league, Grim.
And the fans sure love it.
And
they're like a pinata at a Mexican birthday party. Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid. I'm surprised no one uses the electric carving knife anymore, Brick. And he's off to the races! Look at that little mutant run!
I don't think you can say that, Graham!
Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust! In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
And it's first and ten. I don't know if he even had a target on that throw. Second down and ten. First down and one. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkeys getting drafted on his backside from that band Bernie in last year.
Hey, man, how's Kevin with Simo? I am with him and all Simo.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And the QB might as well just bury himself now because, oh, the unstoppable force meets the explodable object. He's at the 10.
He scores!
Come on. should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten. That's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Grim, why is it that more mentally disturbed?
Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first timeout.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
Second and three. Kind of reminds me of that painting of Dad carving the turkey. Grandma. Timeout is called by the quarterback. They have one left. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and ten. The quarterback burns his last timeout. They can't stop the clock anymore. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Same as Brits' ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a compliment.
And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Turner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and ten. Call man about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
And that'll be second down and 4. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade.
The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? Huh? I'm going to go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down, just pet pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Up about six on the play. And that'll be second down and four. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have to made it to dice rim.
And it's first and ten. They've called a zap attack. The ball carrier, man, he just laid the wood on him on that one and knocked the ball out. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Touchdown!
He is really getting down out there.
You know, he spends most of his days roasting in the pits of hell, so he's got to make the most of every opportunity to dance. The offense is down to their last running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. And that's a returnable ball.
Returnable? You mean he can get a refund for it?
No, Bricks. It means he can return it for... You know what? Never mind. Man, it's pretty hard to hold onto a ball when your brain, heart, and central nervous system stop functioning. So I can't really blame this guy for the fumble. And that's a fumble recovery in return for a touchdown! What a great defensive play! The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And the kicker just bit the dust on that play. Someone will have to come off the bench to replace him. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! You've got to avoid those spikes or you'll be a mutant pincushion.
I was a chubby kid, Grim. My parents sent me to fat camp. My big brother told me as soon as he gets you. So I get off the bus at the camp, some kid runs up to me and stabs me.
And it's first and ten. Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe out the dinosaurs.
Must be opposite day, because he's the one who just got wiped out.
Man, oh man, he hit that line the way your wife
fits the all-you-can-eat buffet of crab apple trees, Bricks.
You're telling me. She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her low intestines just exploded.
No, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
You're telling me.
And the quarterback calls a sonic blast, dirty trick, and throws a supersonic. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
First down and 9. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 5. They called a warp speed dirty trick. He's so fast he watches 60 minutes and 60 seconds. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And there's a huge gain, and this offense is rolling.
Marvin, that was a pass play. Rolling plays are in bowling.
If they don't pick it up here, they are giving a gift to the defense. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes wrong.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. Oh, he goes. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond.
Playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And it's first and 10. A lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up, and the offense is down to their last the running plays. And it's first and 10. First and 10. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, netting him a pickup of about 8 on the play. Second down and 2. Third down and, well, good luck. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. First and 4. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. First and 10. And he's off to the races.
He's at the 20. The 10. And he scores! And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sits up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big peg, Rim. You're right.
Oh, with the brutal hit. First and 10. The nastiest dirty trick in the MFL. He's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. At some point, they're going to need to put this ref out of his misery.
How about now, for instance? Here's a hint. Dirty tricks, attack the ref.
First down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile. Pow! With the brain scrambler. Second down in a mile. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to fight it.
Third down and long.
I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. First and 10. You've got to catch that. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. A Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The kicker's gonna have to kick the ball just right so his team can recover it. That's a bad kick, and it's gonna cost them some yards. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and ten. Today. He was right. Second down and 10. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage and plays really fast.
Why would they do it?
Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. And it's first, and he takes a timeout here. They have two left. I wonder if he has a plan.
Well, maybe he's just gonna take the teeth out of the back of his neck that have been stuck there since the opening play.
Oh, great catch! And that's a touchdown! Touchdown! Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just...
The Colts walk away victors today.
Yeah, except for that one guy down the field with his head knocked off.
The entire game was trench warfare. Both teams battling back and forth, bruised and battered, but in the end, there could be only one winner.
There are winners in my book. I think that a defeated team should get a participation award because I tried really hard.
Why don't you try real hard to shut the fuck up?
Nice mouth. Why why don't you try to lay off the Scots, Junior?
Suck on it.
Real nice. Let's go to the game's MVP. With Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. and all the folks at Evil SN want to thank you for watching this presentation of the Mutant Football League.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right.